Assalamu alaikum, bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Today I kept my presentation simple. Usually I have like videos and very interactive slides, but today I decided to keep it simple. And I thank Mr. Nick on his talk as well. He's one of my mentors actually, and the inspiration for Dubai Blockchain Center. As you know, Nick started one of the first, if not the first, Bitcoin center in the world, and he started a revolution by convincing the actual leaders of cryptocurrency movement to actually look at Bitcoin. I encourage you to look at the movie Banking on Bitcoin. If you have Netflix, that's also free, so you can watch it there. And it is really an inspiration, and it's really an honor to have him here, and it's really an honor to talk after him, actually. So that being said, Dubai Blockchain Center was created with the idea to change the world, not only Dubai, but change and lead in the blockchain space. And not only to lead when it comes to cryptocurrencies, but also blockchain technology itself. And just recently, a couple of days ago, Sheikh Hamdan tweeted that all payments in Dubai will be now done on a unified payment platform called Dubai Now. But to do that, and you'll notice that this was two tweets right after each other, that we'll need to have the actual underlying for that. What do we need to do to have a payment uniform, uniform payment platform? We need to actually first digitize. We need to go completely paperless. We need to enable technologies such as electronic payments. For that, we need not only paperless strategy, we'll need blockchain technology to help it out with the auditing. We need digital signatures. We need identity, digital identity that's not centralized, that is actually federated and you're recognized worldwide. Just like when you have your passport from any country that's recognized in the world, that passport is recognized as your identification anywhere you go in the world. And digital identity should be no different. So one of the things we created as Dubai Blockchain Center was a company to actually help government departments and private sectors to, you know, adapt to the way of how Dubai does this business, how Dubai innovates, how to lead and copy and model the Dubai thinking and strategy and work rate that we have. What are the factors for success? How is Dubai doing all this innovation? How your organization can improve from that experience? And we have actually issued a number of publications that I will share with you later in the slides. But more importantly, we actually consult people on and handhold people throughout blockchain projects, and not only that, but also AI and also adoption of cutting edge technologies within your business. If you have an idea and you want to capitalize on it, we actually help you with that as well. Excellence stands for acceleration, so to accelerate your project as an entrepreneur or startup. Brilliance and also excellence. So please feel free to contact us to learn more about what we do and what we can do for you as Excellence. Going back to Blockchain Center, the center is actually very close to here, it's in the same building literally, in Emirates Towers, and it's in an area called Area 2071, and that's the area basically. It's a co-working area, it's an accelerator as well, and it's also a collision space for people from all walks of life, from all innovations and all sectors, such as biomedical engineering, AI, 3D printing, even robotics that will be launched, hopefully, inshallah, soon, and also blockchain technology. So what do we do as Dubai Blockchain Center? So what we do is we host community events for the blockchain and crypto spaces. We actually do education and training, and I'll talk more in depth about those things. And we have an incubator program where we host, and we have already hosted and graduated some of the programs out of our center. And we are actually a talent pool as well. And we announced last year that we are launching a recruitment and challenge platform as well. And there is also another challenge platform that is actually built by Area 2071 that can be used. So two different challenge platforms. One is for the area itself, and one is for specifically done for blockchain, using blockchain as the platform for that challenge platform that's done with one of our partners from actually France. So in Area 2071, we have something called Country in Residence Program. And every certain period of time, we have host countries that or guest countries that come and take residence within Area 2071 and bring their best startups and best ideas to work here with government departments and the private sector in Dubai and the whole United Arab Emirates. And of course, we also conduct a lot of workshops. We advertise for this all over the world, and we, as a result of that, we have a lot of international alliances, and I'll go over that in the slides as well. To raise awareness about what we do and to raise awareness about cryptocurrency ecosystem, we also have our own podcast. It's called Encrypted, and I think we have more than 50 episodes right now. That's run by two gentlemen or three gentlemen, that Ahmed, Faisal, and one more guy that I don't remember the name of right now. But that's Ahmed and Faisal. And I usually co-host, and every once in a while, we have also live sessions in that podcast. When it comes to education, we'll do master classes in blockchain as well as in cryptocurrency investment, and we do general beginner classes in blockchain. And we have last year during Dubai Future Blockchain Summit, we announced a partnership with University of Nicosia as well as British University in Dubai to bring an academic program from University of Nicosia to Dubai. Not only that, but to get it also recognized by the Ministry of Education here and have a master's degree in blockchain and cryptocurrency, not just blockchain itself, and also have professional certifications, also C-level executive certifications and programming certifications in different platforms such as Ethereum, Hyperledger, Corda, and others. And we continue to bring in new projects to the region. One of our initiatives from last year, as a result of our visit to Australia, we brought in an online education platform called Blockchain Collective, and that's actually an online platform. And not only we're bringing that platform to Dubai or the UAE or the GCC region, but to the whole Middle East region. And that's that announcement and the official details and how you can register will be on our website very soon. We also do investor drives, investor events, road shows, sometimes by ourselves and sometimes with international partners. And we do also inside sessions. We are, as Blockchain Center, we're part of something called Blockchain Global, led by Mr. Sam Lee. And we have sometimes insight sessions where they come over here or we go to the other sister blockchain centers from all over the world. I think we have 15 centers as of now. Speaking of research and publications and that kind of stuff, we had our first book launch last year as well during a gaming and blockchain conference that we helped co-organize, and then we actually did a nice event for the book called The Unified Wallet, which is the same idea that Dubai is right now doing and living the actual ultimate goal of having something like a unified payment system and wallet. Our idea is money should be seamless. We should not think about, when I have to pay for someone, I have to go to their website. You can have one place where you can see all the payments that are due to you and it should be done either automatically or you can authorize certain payments, or you can bulk them up and pay all of them at once. Basically convenience for payments. And cryptocurrencies and the cryptocurrency ecosystem, including and not limited to smart contracts, enable these kinds of innovations to happen and enable these kind of user journeys, which are seamless, to actually happen very smoothly. And we also published not only on cryptocurrencies and wallets and payments, but also on how do you do blockchain projects. Before you start a certain project, what are the things you should consider during the implementation phase? What are the caveats? What are the pain points that you will face that you should, you know, anticipate and account for and plan for? And also, once you reach your milestones within your project, how to expand that and how to create a huge ecosystem and bring in other stakeholders into that ecosystem. You have to design it from the beginning to be an open platform where it actually enables people not only to come in, but also to exit freely. One of the things that we've done as well, and both of these publications, this one and this one, we actually have in Arabic and English. I just wanted to show that we have Arabic as well. And this is the simplifications of the ADGM regulations that were launched by ADGM last year in Abu Dhabi. And a lot of people were finding it really hard to consume the content that was there. It was a lot of documents that are linked to other documents, and it was a lot of jargon that was not familiar to people in the crypto ecosystem. It was basically fintech jargon and some crypto-related jargons, and they were not defined in a central place, but they were all over the ADGM website. So what we did is we did that research. We brought everything together with the help of our legal advisors, Carm Legal, and they actually did an excellent job in doing the English version, but the Arabic version was ununderstandable. So I helped them basically translate it to Arabic and made it really readable and easy to extract information out of it. If you wanted to do your own crypto exchange, OTC desk, or any other crypto ecosystem business. And Damo is here, one of the authors of this book, actually. He is the author, actually, of this book. And basically, the book signing is done in Area 2071, in the 3D building just close to the Emirates Towers, Dubai Future Academy building, basically. And that's basically a time capsule book. Damo, you want to talk about it? No? Okay. So tomorrow from 5 to 7 p.m., please put that in your calendar. Please, if you have to, take a picture. And if you need more details, you can get in touch with Damo here or myself, and I'll let you know all the details about the book. It's basically a time capsule from the Dubai perspective on cryptocurrencies and blockchain technology, and what is the future for that. We don't only do book launches and events for education and that kind of stuff. We also do investor drives and investor-related events, and also investment educational classes, and also fintech classes. We've done one with Corda, as you can see here on the left. And we do it also for law enforcement, for KYC AML entities, for lawyers as well. We've done with Galadari Law and Carm Legal as well. And basically to help people be educated and create an ecosystem where startups can actually find people and VCs and family offices. And we have Mr. Ritoso here from the family event as well, who helped us a lot actually in taking on some of those crypto and blockchain related businesses into his own event. And yes, and we're very thankful for that. And we have other events as well that we do within the center itself. There are smaller events with invite only, no more than 100 investors from both family offices and investment and VCs hosted in our location, basically. One of the events that we started last year with a partner that does gaming, we created this unique event, which is a blockchain and a game summit. And basically what we aim for is to create an ecosystem of payments within games or cross games as well. I'm sure you're all familiar with CryptoKitties, but we take this a couple of steps further. Not only that, not a lot of countries, not a lot of regions, not a lot of blockchain white papers or research talk about gaming. Everyone seems to be missing the whole point about blockchain and gaming. They're both digital, they both have payments, they have in-game items, and it makes sense that we at least should consider using this technology within gaming and within VR, AR, and mixed reality. So the whole point of this conference is to open up that conversation and get people talking together and have this collision space between blockchain experts and gaming experts. Speaking of opening the door and enabling, we actually in Dubai and in the whole UAE actually created an enabler for cryptocurrency and blockchain technology, which is digital identity, which was a huge and still is a huge challenge for blockchain technology. Identity that is federated, identity that is self-sovereign, and we have actually done our version of that. It is not based on blockchain, but it is quote-unquote blockchain ready. It's based on PKI, and we have actually, if you ask for it, we can actually give you access to our developer portal for this, to develop apps and tie it to this kind of identity, which is called UAE Pass. When it comes to regulations, as you know, the UAE has its first regulations out of ADGM, and like I mentioned earlier, we had a document simplifying that. But also recently, we had, sorry, I don't have the slides for that, but we had a lot of talks with the law enforcement, we had a lot of talks with regulators here. We actually launched another opinion paper or position paper out of Securities and Commodities Authority just recently this month. And we also have something which I'm part of, which is called the Dubai Future Councils, and a future council on blockchain. And within that council, we actually created a team that is led by myself on meeting all the stakeholders necessary to come up with a universal or a unique collaborative opinion on the position of the whole UAE, not only in free zones, but in mainland UAE on things like tokenization, cryptocurrencies, and other ecosystem-related regulations that will enable things like blockchain technology and beyond, DLT in general. And I think that is important to open that conversation from now to actually engage the stakeholders, and it has to be coming from the top, as with the Dubai Future Foundation and the Dubai Future Councils, which include people and experts from local Dubai government, entrepreneurs here in Dubai, internationally, and also from other regions like Malta and Canada and the US. So we're looking forward to come up with that. And if you think that you can contribute to that, please reach out and let us know, and we can work together on creating a regulation not only that suits Dubai, but like I said, our vision as Dubai Blockchain Center is not only to serve Dubai, but to serve the world from Dubai. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Marwan.